Hi Sagittarius, welcome to Miracle the Tribe. This is going to be for December 2018, Sun, Moon and Rising. Guys, the audio is terrible. It sucks. So if you want to listen to the entire video, then good luck, because I feel the audio is very, very terrible and I'm not able to fix it. So yeah, I'll still go on with the reading because I have to complete a December batch monthlies, because some people are waiting for the videos. Let's see, and maybe I won't be posting from next year, not ever, but it's just like I'm not too sure. If I invest my time here and I don't have good equipments here, so until unless I'm in a better surrounding, I think I should stop doing videos, because it takes my time and I don't even reach out to many people, so it's of not much use. So I should better be focusing on my studies instead. I feel that's something I should do. And let's see what's coming up for Sagittarius. Enough about me. okay. So Sagittarius, there is something hidden, something that is confusing, or something that is just in the dark, and you feel there can be someone hiding information from you. You feel that there can be someone sly that you are dealing with. It can be a Pisces person or a Cancer person, and you want to move away from this conflicting situation where you are a lot more in your head. But here you have a fulfillment of choice or your wishes. So there is some fulfillment of wishes, and then there is some deception, and then you are moving towards something new. And then there is some things that are unknown, uncertain. So maybe it's just that you are moving to some place new, and things are not clear yet. Where are you going? So let's see. What are the messages coming in for Sagittarius, Sun, Moon and Rising, December 2018? One last shuffle. December 2018, Sun, Moon, Rising for Sagittarius. You have few more flippers here, so I'm gonna take them. Nine of Wands, the Hermit, and Four of Pentacles, along with the Mother of Swords. You can be dealing with a Virgo or a Taurus, Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. You might be hiding your feeling from this person, or this person is holding something back. They might not be sharing some resources or their feelings with you. You might be feeling exhausted, or this person is very exhausted fighting for your affection, or you are exhausted fighting for your, this person's affection. There is somebody who is sitting isolated, sitting all by themselves, looking at life, looking at world from their point of view, and they're trying to understand something. They're trying to be a little bit philosophical in a way. It can be you as well. So this is somebody who has gone on a journey in search of themselves, or in search of meaning, or in search of purpose. But this person was fighting for a very long time for something. This person got exhausted, but they still have fight left in them. They can still fight that battle, and this can be you. You still want to fight for something, but before that, I feel you are going into seclusion. You want to figure things out alone, and I think you will decide either to start saving money or start holding yourself, like creating a boundary where nobody is coming without your permission, or nobody is violating your boundary, and you are speaking your mind. You are being very direct. You're being very like, you don't want to be taken for granted, is one of the messages that I'm getting. And I'm also getting either you're dealing with somebody who has gone through a lot and they're not opening up easily, and or this is just you. You might have gone through a lot of things and it has made you a little bit cold. So let's see what's coming up for Sag, Sun, Moon and Rising. By the way, Jupiter is moving into Sagittarius. Mercury is retrograde right now in Sagittarius. So you might be reviewing few things that happened in the past, and be mindful of how you speak, because you might be blurting things out without thinking, and you can be dealing with a water signs or a child, someone who is naive, selfless and very playful, someone who expresses their feelings without thinking. They just tell you, like, they find you sweet or they find you lovable, or this can be just you finding something within yourself which is like childlike, finding a child within you. And then 8 of cups with temperance, this is you. So 8 of cups, I'm sorry to say this, but I feel some of you are separated from your child or something that was very emotionally close to your heart, and you are moving away from a love offer, some of you, and you want to maintain a balance. You are moving away from something that was not emotionally fulfilling. You feel you were not offered a heartfelt apology or heartfelt love. You feel that you could have been offered something more. This can be you, or this is coming towards you in the month of December. Now let's see what's coming up for Sagittarius. Ace of Pentacles, heart of the matter is Ace of Pentacles with the Sun crossing. Then the Father of Cups is the bottom, then the Chariot, Emperor, three major arcana already, and the Three of Swords. Then your card is also here. You are coming up as yourself, so that's good. Then Four of Wands, then Nine of Wands is coming up again. It has already come up once. Now this card is also coming up again, so this is definitely you or somebody holding something back from you. The World card, okay, and the Father of Swords. So definitely you are ending something that was not serving you, and you're being very, very strict, very professional. You're also hiding some information. You want to hide a information regarding something, like you are trying to move away from something and you want to do it very quietly. You don't want to make any noise. You just want to make a move. You want to move away from a place which was unhealthy, and you're doing it very quietly. And in future, I see that you are having a heartbreak because of a fight, because of a very bitter fight, like an ego battle. And somebody is talking in a very blunt, hurtful manner here. It can be Libra, Aquarius, Gemini. I'm also getting that you are trying to juggle two people or two job, or you are multitasking and you are trying to keep your emotion balanced, and you are quite successful, or you are deciding on a water sign, Pisces, Scorpio, Cancer. Maybe you are choosing a water sign between two people, and in past you were trying to make a new movement, like you are moving towards something. Like your destiny. In past you started moving towards something, and right now you have come to the opportunity, like you do have a opportunity right now, but something is stopping you. It can be your child, it can be success, it can be somebody else's success, or somebody else's ego, or somebody else's pride. What can also be stopping you is that let me see. Okay, so what's stopping you is that something is coming down for you, like something that you had built with a lot of care and a lot of, like you had to supervise something, you were really building it and you were totally invested in it, but then it came down, it crashed, and then it made you really, really sad. It can be with a Scorpio or a Leo Sun Moon Rising, or a Aries Sun Moon Rising. So this still makes you sad. You are still not over that phase, because it was very beautiful and it was very, very successful. So these are the cards. These are your challenges. So you are sad about something which was very beautiful, very, very happy, successful, prosperous. So, but now you have a new beginning here. So it's up to you if you want to take up this new beginning or you just want to miss it. So there is a fresh start. In past you started moving towards something and now you have a opportunity to realize, to make something real. By the way, bottom of the deck is the Pisces card. So you are trying to understand the situation from a broader perspective. You are trying to look at it from higher perspective. You want to be broad-minded, and because Mercury is in Sagittarius, you will be broad-minded, or you should be broad-minded. You cannot be narrow-minded. So think from take a holistic view, and you want to be the boss. You want to be in authority. You want to take charge. You want to take control. You want to supervise. You want to direct people. You want to command. You want to be, I don't know, like it. You just want to be recognized as a boss, basically. However, the best part is people are seeing you as somebody who has things in balance, somebody who is calm, cool and collected, so that's nice. But what I'm also getting here is that you are deceiving somebody or somebody is deceiving you, and you are either moving away from that deception or you are moving quietly away from something by restoring balance. You are trying to hide something in order to restore balance. It can be at home place, or you are for some of you, you are becoming single, and there was some home commitment, something new. There is still there, so maybe you are either committing to something like a single life, or you are committing to a new lifestyle or a new home or a new surrounding. But I have Three of Cups, so either there is somebody around you who is in a three-party situation, or you are celebrating your new move with a friend or lot of friends or family, because you do have a family card and a friend card. So either there are three people in your family who are shifting to a new home, because this is also a home card, so there feels like a commitment, something related to homecoming or something like moving into a new home. But still, this card is also coming, like either you were single for a very long time, or you want to be single, or you want to stay single, and you are deciding that you're not going to get married. I'm also getting that somebody here is celebrating the idea that they will be single for the rest of their life, and that's okay for them. I'm getting that. This is basically somebody around you. This is not coming up as you. This is somebody around you. I'm also getting here that if you are dealing with somebody, if they were your family, there can be a three-party situation, and they want to be independent, they want to be single for now, okay? And like I said, there can be somebody juggling two people, so that makes sense. Like, you might be you might understand the situation really well and you want to sneak out. However, your fear is that you are exhausted and you don't want to fight anymore, or you feel that you don't have any fight left in you. It can also mean that you feel that you are impatient, or you don't want to have any patience anymore. You feel that whatever you had invested in will go to waste. I'm also getting that you are afraid of bad luck, like something will turn out bad, or it will collapse, or it will not be in your favor. So, but all these things are your fear, and if you're feeling like things will be in your favor, you're hoping that things will be in your favor, you are hoping that somebody will fight for you, or you are hoping to fight your battle and you are trying to keep your patience. You don't want to give up, but at the same time it's taking you a lot of patience in order to not give up. Also, I'm getting here that the outcome here is telling me you have to be very professional, strict, and you have to keep things to yourself for a little while, and things are coming to full circle and they are closing out, like the year 2018 is closing out. The world card is there, and let me check. There was something passionate in the past, something very passionate and burdensome as well. You can be dealing with a Capricorn or fire sign or a Pisces. So because of that burdensome situation, you might have gone into isolation and you wanted to get back your power. You have a wish fulfillment because of that discovery, whatever that you discovered in your isolation. I'm also getting, if you're dealing with a Virgo person, then they are on your mind and you want this person for yourself. And you are excited about something new, starting something new, and you're also excited about a very transformative journey with a person who is probably very passionate about you, and or it can be just you very, very passionate about a new beginning or a transformation that you are going to go through. I'm also getting here that your life is definitely changing here because of the something meaningful is happening, because you have the Death, you have the Hermit, you have the Hangman, you have the World card, you have the Temperance. So something very wise is happening, something very transformative is happening, something old has come down. You had a tar and it used to make you happy, that's why you are sad right now, because with the Sun you had the Five of Cups. But presently what do you have is the new opportunity. It's up to you if you want to take this opportunity. In future you do have a heartbreak, so you're trying to keep your balance. This heartbreak is also telling me that if there was a three-party situation, that's true, because you have Three of Swords, you have Three of Cups, you have the Seven of Swords. So you do realize that there is some deception going on, but because Seven of Swords is coming up on your card, I can't say if it is you deceiving somebody or somebody deceiving you. Okay. And but what I feel here is that you will keep your patience, or you're trying to keep your patience, but something will end no matter what, and you are trying to keep your composure. This is also about keeping to yourself, not letting people in. There is somebody around you who is acting single. Maybe they are in a relationship with you, but they're acting single. It can be anyone. Aries, Scorpio, Cancer, Virgo, because I saw almost all the cards, Pisces. Okay, now let's see. One advice card for Sagittarius. Advice is the same as the your last card was this. Your outcome card was Father of Swords. So advice card is same, like be very cold, professional, believe in the facts, don't get carried away by your feelings, note down everything that is happening and make your peace with it, accept it, don't get carried away by your emotions. Bottom of the deck is the World card, so this was also your outcome card, so I cannot emphasize more. Things will come to an end in the month of December, and accept that ending. There will be some transformation for you, and this is a wonderful reading. I don't usually ask for advice card, but yes, there is a three-party situation. I just parted the deck from middle and this was the card that showed up, and this is your ending. Oh god. And yes, there is someone struggling to juggling two people, and there is a three-party situation and there is an ending to that situation. I think some of you just wanted a confirmation, so you are getting that confirmation. It may not apply to everybody, but some of you here really, really wanted a confirmation if somebody was in a three party and you just wanted to be clear on that, and that's what you are getting here. Yes, there is a three party. Yes, you have to end it, and yes, there is a new beginning for you. So yes, do that. Mysticism. So you are believing in something. Mysticism is basically this. Tarot reading is also mysticism. Maybe you are taking help of mysticism to figure out something. And then you have expansion. So Jupiter in the sign of Sagittarius is also going to be a lot of expansion for you. So you have to go out there in the world, be confident, and meet new people. Expansion is, you will have good luck, because you were fearing that you will have a bad luck, but no. You are hoping that you will have a good luck, and since Jupiter is moving into the sign of Sagittarius, which is its own sign, you will have good luck, Sagittarius. So perception, so your overall energy was also Hangman, which was about perception. So you are trying to look at things from positive and broader perspective. You are also very focused on your heart chakra, so heal your heart chakra. Do a heart chakra meditation, healing meditation, guided meditation from YouTube. It will help you. Now let's pull out one more card from this deck. I need message for Sagittarius for December 2018. What is already with you? I think Scorpio also got this. What is already with you? So, and then listening for truth. You need to listen to your heart. I think you are asking wanting question or answers from other people. When you do know the truth, what the truth is, you already know it, but you just want to be confirmed. You just want to hear it from other people. But I think you do know the truth, because you came up as Temperance. Temperance is also someone who is very blessed and guided by the angels. And so you are protected. You have to go on a journey here, Sagittarius, because you got very, like, almost all the major arcanas, which are about transformation. Death is about transformation. Hermit is about transformation. You know, going within and looking for answers. Exploring your subconscious. Then Hangman is all about looking at the world from a different, better, broader perspective, trying to make sense of the things, how things are happening, why they are happening, why the universe is working the way that it is working. And then you had Temperance, which is about wisdom. You had Sun crossing you, so either you are dealing with a Leo who is not supportive of you, or you are getting too much success, or you want too much success and you're not able to begin something because you are already thinking about the result. You had Emperor is about being a little bit egoistic as well. So if you are being egoistic, drop that. But it is also about being in power, being in authority. So maybe you are taking your life back into your hand, and you're letting anything go which is not serving you, or you are not trying to be submissive. You are taking charge. And I think that were all the major arcanas that you got. And then Three of Swords in your future was telling me that there will be heartbreaks of some sort. But because you had Temperance as coming up as you, so I think you will be able to handle it. So that was your reading, Sagittarius, for the month of December. Let's see if I'll be able to, if I'll be posting for the year 2019. Happy New Year. Take care.